after that, you can move towards a citizenship. We have found in India that most of the clients that are looking at residency programs, they are basically individuals seeking a second home, or they want a base for their international business activities. A lot of them want to try out. They want to, you know, they want to see what are their options. They want to go and check out the country. So the residency becomes very popular for them because, I've got that black answer, 5 minutes left. So a lot of people like to, you know, because they like to keep their original passport, which is what the original, what residency financing does for you. We're able to keep your passport and yet have all the benefits of residence. Citizenship financing, by the way, aid programs for Canada and USA, they want to see your intent. So that is why they want you to come and live there for a certain time. Countries like Greece and other European countries are not particular about the stay over there. It could be a short stay, they're not looking at long or permanent stay, except for, there are a few exceptions like Malta, etc. And the Caribbean passports, of course, are do not look at a stay there, but the Caribbean passports exercise a lot of due diligence. The panel spoke about due diligence earlier. I'd just like to add here that it is a critical component as it safeguards national security, protects the country's reputation, to ensure that the applicant is a safe addition to the country. And the more detailed the framework, by the way, the greater is the integrity of the program. Just an idea about the popular immigration programs around the world. We'll go on quickly to the next slide. And we have seen that recently a lot of new countries, you know, seeking out new ways to generate capital and attract talented and wealthy individuals are today looking at the RRI and the CDI programs, and most of them are from Asia, Eastern Europe, Central and South America. But here's a question for all of you. Which is the country this year which is taking over, creating a lot of wealth and attracting? Well, I won't take much more time, Navinji. I'll answer the question straight away. It's the UAE. I think most of you here would agree that the UAE has taken over in the last couple of years, especially after the agreements between the governments and proximity to India. A lot of people are going there, and we have a fabulous residency program with our company formation, with our partners, Medan Free Zone. And is that the next slide? Yeah. So here I would now ask Piyush, our CEO at View Digital, to come, because I think the best person to talk about it, since he himself is going in for a UAE residency. So with that, I hand it over to him, and thank you so much for your attention.
Thank you, Shani. So I become the speaker between you and London and UAE or any other program. And I think the UAE became a first step for me to explore global citizenship. And the reason why this is being done is, if you look at, we've talked about it, Medan Free Zone is really a very interesting proposition. Across the multiple free zones, you're 3 days per wall, but this means in the heart of Dubai, provides several advantages. It gives you a 2-year residency visa, which is renewed automatically if the company still exists. I have an Emirates ID, I can walk in and out in the UAE. And that's the kind of advantage. I have a bank account, I can start transacting. I have 0% personal and company concerns that have always been, oh, Middle East, what do I do about a local partner? Can I really open up a company there? Yes, you can. It's 100%. You can own that country. You don't need a local partner. 0% income tax. Again, this is a free zone activity. So even if the 90% corporate tax is applicable, it won't be in most cases. Global reach. We talked about it. Residency visa. One of the most important things. And other various.
Pereller.
For the last 40 years, there's more depreciation. So if you look at it from a currency risk and a currency risk and a currency hedge perspective, it's absolutely one of the most safest investments we can make. Get lots and lots of things. I won't get into all of this, but again, as a residence permit, you can actually go and live, work, get employed in other companies if you want to. If it's a personal investment and you want to live in the UAE, this is a very interesting proposition. I want to just take a minute and talk about Deal Digital. So you hear Deal Digital, you hear Migrate World. Migrate World is self-explanatory. Deal Digital, what does it mean? Are you a digital company, etc.? Well, we are a 2015 established company, listed on the NSE stock exchange. 35 locations, 6 countries, 5 million plus applications processed. What do you mean by that? We are a visa processing company. We operate visa processing centers for Malaysia, Bangladesh, Georgia, at the back end, London, and a few small ones as well. We are a very, very strong partner for migration to Migrate World. We are the exclusive partners for Migrations in India, and very, very strong verification technology that we are now developing, and we are actually deployed it in Georgia. I'm just giving you the sense of what we are, and we are here to serve all our stakeholders and yes, to help you with our businesses. Thank you, PhD, again for a wonderful event and to invite us here to make this presentation. As a global citizen, namaste.
Thank you very much, Michael Trott and Deal Digital. So any questions and all, we can take lunchtime and at the booth also. So thank you, Sharvizi and Piyush, for your time here. So we'd like to just... break for lunch.